But he made quite a bit of money back, primarily selling to those same businessmen, paintings that he had created. So they were very interested in supporting. It was such a success, I don't know why they didn't do it again. But it was quite a successful moment and a wonderful way of supporting an artist by coming up, by pooling their resources and allowing the artist time off to create all the time.
I was going to ask you, did that type of semi-quasi-cabinet system, did that happen often here in New Point?
No, I mean, it was just one time that I know of here. Businessmen did get together to St. Grant Wood abroad. But I don't know the outcome of that, whether there was a payback involved or not. But I do know in the case of Martin Combs, that it was definitely a situation where he went off, he went down to the Granby building, he painted for, you know, for half a year until he was sent to Mexico for writer pictures. And then they had this there, which we have documented in photos.
Thank you. I just one more thing I want to say is that I think it was in third grade that I copied a book red-headed woodpecker, and then entered it in the show. And it was either in the Coliseum building or here, where all these pictures were hung, and one of mine was hung in here. So I copied it. Everything was wrong with the way I did it, and it was. I tried to get over that. But it's so good to come back to these places. So I think that there might be some questions or some challenges. Please bring them out. Yes, Paul.
I wonder if you could talk a bit about the forms of the pots and the subject and that relationship. Seems to me like in the room, the first room, I'm interested in the verticality of many of these pots, standing sort of as sentinels. Almost, I'm struck by the sense of the silhouette of the barns that Cohn depicted, almost as they're standing upright on top of the landscape. So I'm interested in, particularly in the verticality of some of the pots and the barns as subjects on those. Could you speak to that?
Yes, I think that those are my best pieces here, the thin, tall ones. Mm-hmm. And I violate purposely the idea of the Greek problems and how the pieces went on. And I
think the Greeks had more problems than their financial system?
Definitely. So I made them taller than their usual pieces.
Right.
And I do the honest shape that I put on. But then also the idea of a good life, everything going, and then I still, there's an underlying thing all through it of the corn growing bigger and the culture going smaller. Mm-hmm. And so I choose them. I hope that's helpful to you to understand. Mulvey is an artist who from Tennessee, and he's an incredible magician of fooling people. And so he's playing with me in the same kind of way. You'll have a response, I'm sure.
Well, I remember when I was a student at South Fair, I had a very hard time getting my pots to be tall and elegant, like many Dean's pots. And so Dean played an important, informative prank on me because he told me he had special rubber bands you could put around your left hand. So that's a really big hand to make them thinner in order to get down his pot. And I was practically in tears coming to him, and I said, I can't get my pots tall enough. I think I may need to use those rubber bands you're talking about.
But a miraculous thing happened. He was just tall then, and look at him now. Yes,
indeed, you're shrinking.
Yes, I was shrinking. Any other questions? Since I will avoid the real answer. I don't know how much longer you can stand. Can you stand 10 more minutes to go downstairs for a minute?
Okay. I have another question here, though.
Okay.
When you're working with your son Gunnar on the large pots, do you say to him, now I want a pot that's tall, and I want a skinny pot, and I want a fat pot? Or how does that work if you
I give the assignment of a certain shape, and I would have him do that exact same shape forever with his variations, his beauty, and his capacity to make better pots of that kind by far than I do. So, given that, he keeps making them better all the time. The same with Wayne with the mini pots. And what happens in that regard is the longer we go, the more we draw together because we're working with each other. So I don't give any assignment except the general shape. And then I watch day by day, they're getting better. And so, you know, after like 2 years of making those tall ones, I could see that he was having a little foot drag. And so we went to a slightly change, and they went smaller instead of bigger because he achieved what he wanted. And also, there is some desire of making some path